Today we're going to be doing a problem with a second derivative test. And in this particular problem, we've been asked to use the second derivative test to determine the nature of the critical points of the function f of x equals x cubed minus 3x plus 1. So remember that the second derivative test, which I've pretty much summarized right here, tells us that if we find the critical points of a function and then we evaluate them in the second derivative, if we get a positive result or a result that's greater than 0, we know that that critical point represents at least a local minimum of the function. And if we get an answer that's negative or less than 0, we know that the critical point represents a local maximum. So what we're going to do in order to use the second derivative test to evaluate the critical points are the following three steps. We're going to find the first derivative, f prime of x, and then the critical points. Then we'll find the second derivative, f double prime of x, and then we will plug our critical points into the second derivative to categorize the or define the nature of each of our critical points. So proceeding here with step one, the first thing we're going to do is find the first derivative. So f prime of x, again, this function is really basic. We're just using this basic function to illustrate the second derivative test. So we'll use the power rule to evaluate each of these terms. So we'll get 3x squared minus 3. The derivative of 1, of course, is 0 because it's a constant. So this is our first derivative, 3x squared minus 3. Now, in order to find critical points, remember that we have to set the first derivative equal to 0 and solve for x. So we'll say 0 is equal to 3x squared minus 3. And now we want to solve for x. And the way we'll do that is by factoring the right-hand side. So we're going to factor out a 3, and we'll get 3 times x squared minus 1. Remember also that we want to factor as completely as possible, and we can still factor x squared minus 1. So we'll go ahead and do that. We'll get 3 times x plus 1 times x minus 1. Now that we've factored as completely as possible, we can define the critical points of f of x. So we'll solve each of these pieces for x. We know that if we set this piece equal to 0, we'll get x equals negative 1. And if we set this piece equal to 0, we'll get x equals positive 1. So we have two critical points of the function, negative 1 and positive 1. So that's the end of step 1. Now, step 2 is for us to find the second derivative. So we already know that our first derivative is 3x squared minus 3. So we'll use power rule again to find our second derivative, and we'll call it f double prime of x. So again, power rule, we're going to end up with 6x. The 3 here goes away, the negative 3 goes away because it's a constant. The derivative of any constant is just 0. So our second derivative is f double prime of x equals 6x. Now, in order to define the nature of each of our critical points, we're going to plug in our critical points to our second derivative function. So we'll be plugging both of these into our second derivative. So let's go ahead first and plug in negative 1. So we'll find f double prime of negative 1. That'll be 6 times negative 1, which is going to give us negative 6. Negative 6 is clearly less than 0, which means if we go back and look at our definition, that this here is true, less than 0, which means that the critical point, x equals negative 1, is going to represent a local maximum. So we'll say local maximum. It may represent a global max, but we would have to determine where the function is increasing and decreasing, and the actual value of each critical point in order to determine whether or not it was truly a global maximum. So now we'll find f double prime of the second critical point. So we'll say 6 times 1. We'll get a positive 6, which is obviously greater than 0. And according to the definition of the second derivative test here, when it's greater than 0, we're looking at a local minimum. Again, possibly a global minimum, but we would have to evaluate in order to determine that for sure. So we have a maximum and a minimum, kind of difficult to remember because it's opposite. Obviously, if the result is less than 0 or negative, it's a maximum. If it's greater than 0, it's a minimum. Just remember that it's opposite in that way. But that is how you use the second derivative test to determine whether or not your critical points represent maximums or minimums. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.